if we can all agree on something, is that the more testimonials you have, the better. The problem is that they can take up a lot of space, so it often makes sense to display them in a single section, using a sliding feature so that visitors can still easily navigate your site. Hi, my name is Robert from Themeisle.com and I welcome you to our channel. In this video, you are gonna learn how to display a rotating testimonials section in the sidebar area of your self-hosted WordPress website. To do this, we are going to use the Testimonials widget plugin. Before moving on to the first step, you'll need to install and activate it. Testimonials widget packs quite a few settings for a plugin with such straightforward functionality. To access them, you'll need to click on the new Testimonials tab from your WordPress dashboard. Instead of going over every single option, we are going to focus on those you'll find most useful. For starters, head over to the General tab and erase the contents of the default reviewed item and default reviewed item URL fields. Since you are going to place your testimonials manually, that information won't be necessary. Then, move on to the Fields section and choose the elements you don't want your WordPress testimonials to include. Each box you tick here will hide a particular item. Deciding which options to keep enabled is up to you, but I recommend you retain either the author or avatar fields. After all, if people can put a face to the testimonial, they'll be more likely to trust it. Once you've made your choices, remember to save the changes. Then, you can move on to the next step. Now that you are ready to add your first testimonial, go to Testimonials, Add New on your dashboard. This will open up the editor and enable you to enter a title and the contents of your client's testimonial. Keep in mind that by default, Testimonials widget doesn't display this title on the front end. With that in mind, we recommend choosing one that will help you identify each testimonial later on. After typing in or copying over your client's testimonial, scroll down to the Testimonial Data section. Here, you can add identifying information about the client. Don't forget that during the first step, you may have disabled some of these fields from displaying on the front end. You can leave those sections blank and simply fill in the rest. When you are done, remember to add a featured image for your testimonial, which will display right next to the text. Let's see how the final product looks on the front end. By default, your testimonial will appear without any customizations. If you want to tinker with your testimonial's style, check out how to customize it using CSS. Then, you can simply repeat this process to create additional WordPress testimonials. Once all the testimonials you want to use are ready, you'll need to add a slider section somewhere on your site. There are two ways to do this. The first is by using the Testimonials slider widget available under Appearance widgets. This method enables you to place your slider either in your sidebar or footer. However, if you want more control over your WordPress testimonials, you're probably better off using shortcodes. Pasting the following shortcode into your WordPress editor will display your slider wherever you place it. Let's check out how this will look on the front end of your site. By default, your testimonial slider will transition from slide to slide automatically. Adding the Show Controls configuration enables your visitors to switch between slides manually instead. If you'd rather use the default settings, all you have to do is remove that section of the code. So, testimonials are a great way to drum up new business for your site. As long as you do a great job for your clients, chances are some of them will be happy to leave you a testimonial. Even a few lines of positive and honest feedback can have an impact on new users and encourage them to convert. Thanks for watching. Click the parrot on the screen right now to subscribe. Then click the bell and check send all notifications for this channel. This way, you'll be notified every time we upload our latest tutorials about WordPress. Share them if you like what you see. Hit the like button and ask any question in comments below.